1, 2, 3, स्टार्ट। इफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ दैट साइड ऑफ द हाउस गो टू सम अदर हाउसेज एंड हियर लेक्चर्स वेरी सीरियसली, दे शुड कम हियर एंड टेल अस दैट दे आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द वेजेस ऑफ द वर्कर्स व्हेन सच मेजर्स आर ब्रॉट अप। सच ओकेजन्स आर गुड ओकेजन्स फॉर देम टू बिगिन टू कल्टिवेट दिस थिंग बिकॉज यू हैव येट टू लर्न द ABC ऑफ सोशलिज्म First, and you cannot write a book or a poem or an article straight away, and we do not expect you to do it either. But if you are really sincere about what you are talking, you should try to learn the ABC, that is to say, begin with giving the workers a fair deal, giving them a living wage, and dealing with the workers here in this bill. You should make provisions for them. I do not suggest to the minister that in this bill there should be provision that so much wages shall be given to the rubber plantation worker or fix a scale and all that sort of thing. All that I have proposed in this amendment is that the board should be given that reorientation of outlook, should be given the direction that the wages have to be increased and that they have to consciously work for it. That is all that I demand in this amendment, sir. We do not like that our workers should be exploited by the people, and he will not deny because it has been pointed out from that side of the house also that huge profits are being amassed. They cannot spend the money. The British who are earning out of this industry cannot spend the money with all their luxury and extravagances. They cannot spend that money here in this country. They send this money abroad. Even then, they retain some money in their hands. They would rather keep them in banks idle than give this money to the workers for bettering their lot, for improving their conditions, which determines in the final analysis whether the production of the country would go up or not. Now, sir, I read with great interest the Select Committee's report, especially the portion of the evidence appended to it, and I would ask you also, sir, to reread, if you have already read, this interesting document. You see here Mr. T.T. Krishnamachari crossing swords with an important representative of the British interest, the British rubber interest in this country. Now it is all a very battle, wordy battle. It is a sort of very interesting competition of for being smart, one trying to overreach another in smartness, but at the same time, out of these discussions it emerges that the British interests are totally unmindful of the interests of the workers, of the interests of the country as a whole. Although the British gentleman who came here to give evidence or spoke of national interest and all that, here you will find many interests. Stop.